أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد النبي العظيم الأمي الأمين، وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. قبل أن نبدأ بالتعريف على موضوع خطبة اليوم، بلغنا خبر وفاة أم أختنا الأخت بسمة، وهي أمها في السعودية. فنحن نتضرع إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى وندعو ونؤمن على دعائك. So, inshallah, before we start, we're going to make dua with our sister's Basma's mother. She passed away in Saudi Arabia, and we got to know just right now. Please, I make dua and you say ameen. Allahumma ghfir laha warhamha. Allahumma ghfir laha warhamha. Allahumma ghfir laha warhamha. Allahumma aafiha wa'fu anha. Allahumma aafiha wa'fu anha. Allahumma aafiha wa'fu anha. اللهم تجاوز عن سيئاتها. آمين. اللهم زد في حسناتها. آمين. اللهم افسح لها في قبرها مد بصرها. آمين. اللهم آمن وحدتها. آمين. اللهم ارحم غربتها. آمين. اللهم لقنها حجتها. آمين. اللهم ثبتها عند السؤال. آمين. اللهم ثبتها عند السؤال. آمين. اللهم أكرم نزلها. آمين. ووسع مدخلها. آمين. اللهم جاف الأرض عن جنبيها. آمين. اللهم افتح لروحها ابواب السماء. اللهم عمها بالرحمه والرضوان. اللهم اسكنها فسيح الجنان. اللهم اسمعها سلاما سلاما. اللهم اسمعها سلاما سلاما. اللهم اجعلها من اهل الجنه. اللهم باعد بينها وبين النار. اللهم لا تحرمنا اجرها ولا تفتنا بعدها. واغفر لنا ولها. اللهم اغفر لنا ولها ولوالدينا وسائر المسلمين. صلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد واخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. موضوع خطبة اليوم كان عن قيمة الوقت من ناحية، وعن الانتباه لسرعة مرور الأيام، لأننا في نهاية عام ونستقبل عاما جديدا. فالمسلم العاقل هو الذي يعتبر بمرور الأيام، كما بدأنا في الركعة الأولى: إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب. Indeed, in the creation of the heavens and the earth, in the alternation of the day and night, there are a lot of signs for those who have a mind, for those who have, you know, they look at things from a mindful way. So we try to prove that we need to make a plan for ourselves in order for us to make up anything that we have missed throughout the last year. And we mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made it obvious and clear that there are two certain blessings that most people, everywhere and every time, they squander, they don't pay much attention to them. Those two blessings are the good health and the free time. نعمتان مغضون فيهما كثير من الناس الصحة والفراغ. يعني الإنسان في حال الصحة ربما يستهلك هذه الصحة في أمر لا ينفعه. والصواب أن يتعاون الإنسان في بناء الخير لبيته، لمسجده، لمجتمعه، لما ينفع الشباب والمجتمع، الكل يتعاون. هذا نوع من أنواع شكر نعمة العافية. والنعمة الثانية هي نعمة الفراغ، حينما يكون عند الإنسان وقت فراغ يستثمره فيما يرضي الله سبحانه وتعالى. ربما يكون فيما يعني يطور من نفسه ويزيد من حسناته ويدعم إيمانه بتلاوة كتاب الله تعالى وبالاستغفار وبذكر الله، كذلك بتعليم من حوله يبدأ بأهله. لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى قال: كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر. فالأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر والدعوة إلى الله والنصيحة واجب كل إنسان، وليس فقط الإمام أو الشيخ أو المعلم، بل هو واجب كل من اتبع النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. So again, we try to emphasize that these two blessings are so important to be taken care of. Our good health and our time. Why our time? Because, you know, days turns to weeks, weeks turns to months, months turns to years, and our whole life is just consists of some years. 60, 70, even 100 years, still it's a time. So when we waste one day of our life, we waste a part of our life. And let me remind you of Ibn Abbas, Abdullah Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him. He said that I've never felt sad except for one thing. One day passing from my life without increasing my good deeds. لم أشعر بالحزن على شيء إلا كيوم مر من عمري دون أن أزيد فيه من الصالحات. عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. فنحن أولى ونحن في حاجة إلى أن نفيق وأن نعتبر بمرور الأيام. أمر الوقت مهم في غاية الأهمية وله أساس في ديننا الحنيف. يعني حينما يحترم الإنسان الموعد يعني يوصفني أن أقول إننا يعني أحياناً بناخدها على سبيل المرح أو الفكاهة يعني يقول لك أنت عربي أو أنت لو معك الساعة 6 تروح 6 ونص لو معك الساعة 7 أنت هناك 8 ونص يعني إحنا بناخدها مرح لكن الحقيقة لو انتبهنا الدين الحنيف ديننا هو من أسس فكرة احترام الوقت والالتزام بالوقت كيف؟ لماذا حضرنا كلنا اليوم الآن في هذه الساعة الساعة الثامنة تماما لماذا حضرنا لكي نصلي إذا هناك موعد مع رب العالمين فكلنا التزم بهذا الموعد فالذي يستطيع أن يلتزم بموعد كل يوم صلاة الفجر صلاة العشاء في أي صلاة يستطيع أن يلتزم بموعد مع صديقه أو إذا دعي إلى مكان إلى آخره So we always say that the concept of respecting our time of respecting our appointments, if you have an appointment with your friend, if you are invited somewhere and you are invited to be there at, let's say, at 7 p.m., so try your best to make it on time. You are able to. They are trying to push us to the edge of, yes, our mindset, and then of the next generation, everyone will take it for fun, and just, you know, we'll make it some jokes that, yes, we got used to, you know, make it later. To get late to our, you know, destination or so. Please try to remove this idea from our thoughts, and then we'll start to appreciate the ni'mah of our religion, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to respect our times. That's why He subhanahu wa ta'ala made it mandatory that we should be praying five times a day in certain times. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا So, the concept of time is related to a salah, which is the fundamental pillar of Islam. The basis of our religion is very related to the concept of time. That it's not up to everyone to pray whenever they want. Rather, we have a certain time to pray. And maybe one of the benefits we get from this prescription, which is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed a certain time for each prayer that we are here now. That we gathered at the time afternoon today to pray Salatul Jum'ah together. If it were not for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who commanded us to pray at a certain time, then we would be just, you know, everyone prays and makes Salah at a different time, and then we lose the importance of gathering and getting together and checking on your brothers and shaking hands and trying to get closer to each other and to make sure that your brother is good and he's doing well and so on and so forth. So again, the concept of time is so related and it's part of our religion. We mentioned something quick about a salah. As zakah, for example, you have a certain amount of money. If you keep it, save it for a whole entire year, then the next year, at the first day of the next year, then zakah is due on your money. This is time that has beginning and has an end. Shahr Ramadan. Once we say Shahr Ramadan, we make it, you know, restricted to the month of Ramadan. That we cannot just take any month to make siyam and say, okay, I'm going to make fasting for 30 days in a row, but I'm going to make it in the month of, let's say, Sha'ban or Rajab or so. You cannot do this, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says Sha'ban Ramadan. Every single day has a certain time from the dawn, from Adhan al-Fajr, to the sunset, to Adhan al-Maghrib. We cannot, if you extend your siyam after Salat al-Maghrib till Salat al-Isha, be sure that you're not going to gain more rewards. No. You might be even lose some of your rewards. Why? If you do it in purpose every day, then you are not following the Sunnah of Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then we are making ourselves in trouble. So again, when we say respecting our time, it's a huge deal in our religion. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes all of the pillars of Islam, all of them, related to the concept of time. Al-Hajj. Al-Hajj wa ashhurun ma'lumat. There is a certain time for Hajj. You could make Umrah any time during the year. But Al-Hajj has a certain time and specific days to go and make Hajj. You cannot make Hajj during the month of Ramadan. Although the month of Ramadan is the best month ever, but you can't say I'm going to make Hajj and okay, I'm allowed to go to Arafat, stand and to climb the mountain of Arafat, I'm going to make Hajj during the month of Ramadan. No, you cannot do this. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says Al-Hajj Arafa, Al-Hajj al-Qubba Arafa, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says Al-Hajj ashhurun ma'lumat, certain months and certain days for Al-Hajj. We are trying to get to the point of respecting our time is part of our religion. It's not new, it's not modern, it's not something that is related to the culture. Even if we fail to make it in a perfect way, we are able to make it related to our religion and gain rewards. If you have an appointment with your friend trying to make it earlier, 5 minutes earlier, or to go on time, and you have in your mind and deep in your heart, I'm doing this out of respect for the time, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it mandatory for prayer, for example, to be prayed in a certain time. I appreciate time from this perspective, you're gaining rewards. And we said before that, alhamdulillah, you have the luxury to turn all of your daily habits to an act of worship. Just the smile you meet someone with, if you have the intention that I'm doing this to bring peace and bring happiness to my friend, to my brother, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَتَبَسُّمُكَ فِي وَجْهِ أَخِيكَ صَدَقَةً. The smile on your face when you meet someone is a kind of charity. As if you took money from your pocket and paid it for the sake of Allah, just to have a smile on your face. Everything we do, we could turn it into an act of worship. And this is one of the things why our religion is unique, that is open for everyone to gain a lot of rewards and to gain the pleasure of Allah through our day-to-day habits. So, towards the end of this year and the new year, let's try to change things to the better. We can't just hit the button and change everything. It takes time. It's a process. But we need to start. This is the point. Just to start. It's like someone who wants to lose weight and will say, I'll start from next week. I'll go to the gym next month, just as myself, by the way. I'll start tomorrow, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Just postponing things makes it difficult. Make a decision and move forward. And don't worry about the results. Just do your role, go step by step, slowly, and the outcome, the result, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you even beyond your imagination. Because everything takes time. When the farmer just put the seeds in the ground, he cannot expect the fruits the next day or even the next week. But it takes time, number one, and it takes effort to go and, you know, pour water, to irrigate and to water the seeds. And also it takes kind of discipline. Discipline and consistency makes miracles. Let's try to start a new year with
changing ourselves, trying to fix our hearts in terms of ibadah. Remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps your heart always clean and soft and very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Making dua every day is kind of ibadah. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. That He gives you what you want, and on top of that He gives you hasanat, just because you got back to Him alone. And what's unique about dua, that we are humbling ourselves only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a great honor. That the more we humble ourselves to Allah, the more we got the honor, and the more we our rank will be high in this life and the hereafter, inshaAllah. نسأل الله تعالى أن يجعل ما مر من عامنا الماضي في ميزان حسناتنا وأن يغفر لنا تقصيرنا وأن يعيننا على رضاه سبحانه وتعالى وعلى اتباع هدي نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم قل قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم وإلى أن نلتقي السلام عليكم ورحمة الله